Hey, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel, and welcome to another great X-Men video.
Beat it, chump!
Okay.
That's right, my friends. It is Spider-Man week, and so in honor of that, we're gonna have Spider-Man content all week, and today we're taking a look at the Superior Foes of Spider-Man Omnibus in honor of all the villains that are gonna be in No Way Home. So without further ado, let's take a look at the book.
As always, here is the spine of the book. Aw, little Omnibus Jr. gonna cry. As you can see, it's a very slim, hardly an Omnibus-type omnibus. And ooh, I'm shaking in my boots. Here's the cover with the very scary, very notable five Spider-Man villains that are in this book featured on the cover. Here's the back of the book, meet the new Sinister Six. And yes, there are really only five of them. Congratulations, you can count. Alright, let's get into the Superior Foes of Spider-Man Omnibus. First of all, dig on what this collects. This collects the Superior Foes of Spider-Man 1 through 17. Simple enough. Okay, worth noting that this is out of print right now, but you can get it for like $100 in certain places if you really want it, the physical copy. But honestly, your best bet is probably just reading it on Marvel Unlimited, and you should, because it's a very absurd, very fun, very comical Spider-Man villain story by Nick Spencer. So really, what is this book? Well, this is a story focused on the brand new Sinister Six, and yes, as mentioned, there are only five of them. The sixth empty chair is meant to be a point of mystery for other people to be like, oh no, where's the sixth guy? You know, don't think about it too much, okay? The team consists of Boomerang, Shocker, Speed Demon, Overdrive, and the new female version of Beetle. Now, some of those are a bit more obscure than others, and you might not even know of if you're not pretty into Spider-Man comics, but don't worry, this book does a good job of fleshing all of that character information out and the dynamics as well. This is another one of those books that does its things in its own way, but is also pretty respectful to source material. It's weird that we got this omnibus and not a Superior Spider-Man omnibus, as this takes place during the time that Otto Octavius is in Peter Parker's body, but this is a good story on its own regardless. The plot essentially is this wacky, absurdist heist storyline, and the point of view character is Boomerang, and he sort of narrates the life of a B-list villain and takes us on this ride of the mess that he's gotten himself into pretty badly. Basically, he owes the Chameleon some debts and puts together this team to steal a fabled item, which I don't think I'll spoil because that is its own fun part of the story too, but it's better than anything that you can probably typically imagine would be associated with a heist. So it's kind of his struggle to keep this team of losers together and capable and, you know, maybe not leave such a huge trail of destruction in the way. There's double crossing, there is murder, there's plotting, there's thievery and all that heist goodness in there. And this book is also just really, really funny. I found myself laughing out loud at sometimes just at the drawings, the dialogue, the characterizations, everything. I mean, this is in no means meant to be taken super seriously, and you know, it's awesome to get something like that every once in a while, and there are many, many character appearances in here that I think are fun revelations that I also don't want to give away, but just know there's a large cast of characters, and we get to see some cool Marvel cameos within here. I should say there is also another item that they're trying to steal, which I will tell you is a painting of Dr. Doom's real face, and there's some classic funny panels that are involved with that too, and I love it. I hope we get this series as like a Disney short, like a Disney Plus series sometime in the future, because I think that would just be super fun, and I think it lends itself to that medium well too. Beetle and Shocker were my favorite characters in this, I think. First, Beetle is actually kind of capable and is very smart, selfish, and has this great wit about her, so it's really nice to see her interact with the rest of the dweebs here. Always made me laugh. Shocker, I just really enjoyed because he is like this super cowardly member of the team, and it's another instance of it just being so funny throughout, and he has a really satisfying vehicular moment at the end of the story. I should mention that I really enjoyed the artwork of Steve Lieber or Lieber, whichever way it is pronounced. I think it's very simplistic, very fun, it works super well for this series, and the layout and design of everything is also really great, and it makes it just feel like you're breezing through this book. You can read this super quickly. One, it's only 17 issues, but two, just the artwork helps the pace, and the dialogue helps, and everything, so it's something you can get through in an evening if you'd really like to. So I do hope you guys get the chance to read this story at some point. Like I said, it's available on Marvel Unlimited. That's probably the cheapest, easiest option to get it right now. You can shell out the $100 for the omnibus if you want, but that is, of course, your choice. I don't know if this one's ever going to get a reprint in the future. Probably the thing they would potentially do is maybe put the content in the Superior Spider-Man Omnibus somehow, if they did like a volume 1 and 2. I don't know. Let's first of all, just before we even focus on getting a reprint of that, let's direct our energy towards the Marvel gods and praying to them to give us just a Superior Spider-Man Omnibus, because I feel like that is a run that we need collected, and I feel like a lot of people would buy it because there's a lot of interest in that run and that version of the character. Alright, that is the video for today, guys. Last parting thoughts from me. You want forgiveness? Get religion. You want to see when I upload new videos? Hit the subscribe button. And don't forget to leave a comment. Chump!